Can you really build muscle with lighter loads? Or is it just endurance and conditioning work? I'm sure you guys watching this video aren't here to get toned by lifting purple dumbbells. Not that there's anything wrong with that. So we need answers. In this video, we'll dig into the research that examined the effects of heavy, moderate, and light loads to achieve hypertrophy, along with other variables that came into play. We'll also discuss the benefits of mixing light load training into your program, and the various techniques you can employ to maximize muscle. For decades, many bodybuilders believed that lifting heavy weights for few reps only built strength, and lightweight for high reps only built endurance. They also thought a bodybuilding rep range of about 8 to 15 reps was best for building muscle. But as more studies on this subject get published, we start to understand that a comparable amount of muscle can be built across a broad spectrum of rep ranges, including lighter loads for higher reps. This 2020 meta-analysis by Grzyk, which included 10 studies, sought to explore the effects of low load versus high load resistance training on type 1 and type 2 muscle fiber hypertrophy. One of the criteria for this meta-analysis was that the sets had to be performed to momentary muscular failure. This is a critical point which we'll circle back to later. The meta-analysis showed no significant differences between low load and high load resistance training on hypertrophy of type 1 or type 2 muscle fibers. One note worth mentioning is that the results presented in this meta-analysis are specific to the lower body musculature, since all studies collected muscle biopsy samples from the quadriceps femoris. Okay, let's focus on a single study that looked at a whole body DEXA scan to see the differences in gains from heavy load versus light load training. This 2016 study by Morton and others compared training with high or low loads effects on muscle hypertrophy. This was 12 weeks of whole body resistance training done with 49 resistance trained males divided into two groups. Here's how they divided the heavy and light load groups. One group lifted light loads of around 30 to 50%, their maximal strength, 1RM, for 20 to 25 repetitions per set. The other group performed lower repetition, using 75 to 90% one rep max of 8 to 12 repetitions. You may notice that the heavy group isn't that heavy, with the lower end of the one rep max being 75%. 8 to 12 reps is a moderate rep range that is considered a bodybuilding rep range. This study helps see how 20 to 25 reps compared to the standard 8 to 12 rep range most lifters use. Full body resistance training was performed 4 days per week, Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday. Each day included 5 exercises, consisting of 2 separate supersets and 1 additional exercise. Exercises were performed for 3 sets. Once again, executed sets were performed until failure. The conclusion was that light and heavy loads effectively induced skeletal muscle hypertrophy in resistance-trained participants when the sets were performed to failure. So why does taking sets to failure result in similar muscle growth with lighter loads? As you take a set to failure, all your muscle fibers are forced to engage, as some fibers become fully fatigued and drop out. This is why the final reps near failure in an 8 to 12 rep range and a 20 to 25 rep range are similar. Now that you know light loads can be as effective as moderate or heavy loads for muscle building, should you stop doing sets fewer than 20 reps? Not exactly. Let's talk about some drawbacks to using lighter loads before getting into the best time to use them. The first drawback of using lighter loads is your strength gains will come slower. While sets to failure with light loads can produce similar muscle growth as heavier loads, the same can't be said for strength gains. This 2014 study compared 3 sets of 7 reps with a moderate load to 7 sets of 3 reps with a heavy load. The researchers equated volume between the two groups. Both groups experienced similar muscle gains, but the group that lifted heavy with 7 sets of 3 reps experienced more significant strength gains. So if strength is important to you, it's essential to utilize sets with heavy and moderate load in your program. Another drawback of using light loads is that it can be impractical for specific exercises. While performing 20 to 25 reps on bicep curls is manageable, doing that with squats can be very exhausting. Your conditioning may be more of a limiting factor than your strength. Now let's cover 3 ways to maximize muscle gains with light loads and the best time to use them. Number 1, blood flow restriction. Blood flow restriction, BFR for short, is a training method that partially restricts arterial inflow and entirely restricts venous outflow in working muscles during an exercise. Another way to look at this method is training a muscle with added pressure. BFR involves applying external pressure, typically using a tourniquet cuff, to the upper region of an arm or lower body limb. An example of this is using a BFR cuff around your upper arm and performing arm curls, or on the upper part of your quadriceps and performing leg extensions. A 2020 systematic review that included 10 relevant studies suggests that the literature supports that BFR can improve strength, muscle size, and sports performance markers in healthy athletes. With blood flow restricted, a muscle can be trained with a lighter load due to an increase in intramuscular pressure beneath the cuff. For most individuals, exercising with loads of 20 to 40% of your maximum muscle strength will likely maximize muscle growth with BFR. The pressure used will vary depending on the equipment used and the preference of the lifter. BFR can be utilized to train around an injury with lighter loads, or can be done when completely healthy. Periods of training with lighter load can help prevent injuries, since training injuries are more likely to occur with heavier weight. Number 2, the finisher set. Another way to totally fatigue muscle fibers and get a serious pump is with a finisher set. This is done with a lighter load and higher reps after your final working sets. There is research that provides a compelling reason to believe that exercise-induced cell swelling enhances hypertrophic gains. The goal is to perform enough reps to cause a pooling of blood in the muscle to promote cell swelling. These finishers can be done in multiple ways. It can be one high rep pump set, drop sets, myo sets, or even static holds with a lighter load. These are all different ways to reduce the load being lifted while maintaining a lot of blood flow to the muscle. Only perform these finisher sets with exercises that are safe to take to failure. This typically involves accessory lifts or bodyweight exercises, where if something goes wrong, you're safe. Avoid doing this with a barbell bench press or barbell squat, where the weight ends up on you once you hit complete failure. Here's a few examples of adding these sets to the end of your working sets. Number 1, multiple sets of bench press followed by max sets of push-ups. Number 2, multiple sets of squats or leg press followed by max sets of leg extensions to total failure. Number 3, barbell bicep curls in the 8 to 12 rep range, followed by a final set with a light load of 15 or more reps to total failure. Number 4, multiple sets of lateral raise, finishing with myo reps until you can't do 3 reps in a row. Number 3, working around pain or an injury. Using a lighter load with high reps can help when training around an injury aggravated by lifting heavier loads. Instead of taking time off from lifting because of a nagging injury, like many physical therapists who don't lift would suggest, adjusting the load you train with is a way to continue to progress safely. Here are two common injuries that this can be applied to with a good physical therapist clearance. Many people experience knee pain when training their legs at some point in their training career. This pain could have occurred from a sudden injury or from wear and tear over time. In either case, performing leg exercises like squats with heavy loads may be unrealistic. An easy workaround is to perform single leg exercises with lighter loads to or near failure. Here's a list of single leg exercises that can be performed safely with lighter loads. Number 1, Bulgarian split squat. Number 2, single leg extension. Number 3, single leg press. Number 4, assisted pistol squats. Anytime you feel pain with a heavier load, try reducing the weight and performing more reps. Really focus on stretching and contracting the muscle on each rep. Pause reps can make lighter loads more effective as well. Shoulder injuries are also prevalent amongst lifters. Shoulder pain can reduce your ability to press overhead. If the pain is bad enough, it can also stop you from performing the bench press with loads you typically use. Two workarounds here are finding grips and angles that you can press with relatively pain-free, and using lighter loads in the 20 or more rep range. There are several muscle-building benefits of using lighter loads in higher rep ranges. These can be utilized to work around injuries, or as a means to prevent injuries when you're healthy. Be sure to mix in light load sets in your training program to mix things up and maximize your gains. If you found this video helpful, make sure you give this video a thumbs up as it would truly help out the channel. Are you looking for a complete, done-for-you training and nutrition guide guaranteed to add slabs of muscle to your frame in the next 90 days? Claim your free copy of our book, Bulk Up Fast. The book has already been paid for. All you have to do is cover the small shipping fee. Just click the link in the description, tell us where to ship it, and we'll send it to you anywhere in the world. And if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe for more videos. And don't forget to turn on post notifications so you don't miss the next one. Peace.